Hello guys, welcome to the first video, Tilt and Pan Camera Animation, from the course 3D Camera Animation Techniques for ArcWiz Artists using 3ds Max. In this tutorial, we will look into how to properly set camera rotation order and reference coordinate system for tilt and pan camera movements in 3ds Max. Since this is the first video of this series, it will be extremely simple. But it will be building your foundation for the upcoming advanced camera rigging and animation tutorials. So without any further ado, let's get started. You should always set your camera rotation order to gimbal reference coordinate system when doing camera animation. If you don't set your camera to gimbal, then you will face this issue. Let's see an example. Go to the camera. I can use 3ds Max standard camera, physical camera, or V-Ray physical camera. I'm going to use V-Ray physical camera, but you can use 3ds Max standard camera as well. So in my top viewport, I'm going to left click here and drag it all the way like this. Now go to the modify panel and uncheck target, because we don't want a target camera for this kind of animation. Now in your perspective or any view of your choice, you can press C on the keyboard or you can simply left click here and select this camera, this one. Now if you want to move your camera little bit back, you can move it. It's all up to you. You are the one who is going to set your camera. So this is my first camera angle, I think. So yeah, I'm just satisfied with it. Next, if you're using V-Ray physical camera, then always click on automatic vertical tilt. But if you're using some other camera, then it's not an issue at all. Now, if I try to tilt my camera using the default view reference coordinate system, then you can see that it is going to give me some strange results. Go to the rotation and start. See the movement. Undo. Again, you can see the movement. Undo. So to fix this, some people go and change the reference coordinate system from view to local. Now, if I try to tilt my camera, you can see that it's perfect. Basically, a tilt animation is up and down movement at the same place. So now you can see, since I'm getting my rotation axis like this, I can very easily up and down my camera like this to get the perfect rotation. Now guys, if you're using only tilt animation, then it's okay. You don't need to change, do anything else. But if you want tilt and pan both at the same time, then you will again going to get into some problem when you try to pan this camera. Now this is the angle that I'm satisfied, and I'm now going to pan my camera. Basically, a pan movement is right to left or left to right rotation at the same place. So I'm going to do like this, and you can see, look at this, my planes, see, building angle and everything. Plus, look carefully here too. I'm just going to undo it, and now you are going to see how my camera is going up like this. Now again, you can see again my camera starts to go like this. Undo it one more time. Now to solve this pan issue, some people go and change the local reference coordinate system to world, and now pan is going to work perfectly. You can see that my camera is flat and panning is perfect now. So in short words, for tilting they use local, and for panning they use world or view. Switching back and forth between reference coordinate system is not a good way to animate. Plus, It is time consuming and it will surely lead into problems in the future. So, to fix this, make your camera align to the grid. I will just simply go 90, 0 and 0. And now I'm going to change my reference coordinate system to gimbal. And I'm going to place it like this. Now, if I want to do tilt, you can see that the tilt is working perfect. Here. And second, if I want to rotate my camera, just watch here. For panning, you can see that my buildings and everything is just perfect. It's not rotating anywhere. Plus, now watch here. See, my camera is flat, no issues at all. So the gimbal reference coordinate system solves this issue of panning and tilting at the same time. We could stop here, but it will be better if we go one step further by setting the rotation axis like the real camera on tripod. Let's see an example. If I roll my camera like this, you can see that the tilt x-axis is also rotating. And now, if I tilt my camera, we are not getting the correct rotation. So undo it two times. It is actually happening because 3ds Max calculates rotation in a sequence. So by default, it will calculate x, then Y and then Z. Real tripod don't work like this. So to correct this, we have to change the rotation order to ZXZ. Now go to the motion panel. Make sure you are on PRS parameters. Click on rotation and change your Euler parameters from XYZ to the last one, that is ZXZ. Now align your camera to the grid 0, 90, 0. Now the setup is complete for the tilt and pan camera movement and everything will be perfectly working. Even it will not create any problems if I roll my camera. See, if I'm rolling it, my X is perfect and you can see like this. Just undo it two times and now do it like this. Now I'm going to animate my camera. Click on time configuration and choose your frame rate. I'm happy with NTSC. If you want to change it, you can change it. As far as the end time is concerned, I will keep it to 350 because I think so I can easily do my tilt and pan movement in these frames. I'm going to click on auto key. Now on the zero frame, I will just select my initial starting camera angle. Now I will go to 150. It's up to you which how long you want, but 150 is fine for me and I will take it down like this. Again, click here like this and you can see it like this. See, my tilt is perfect. To hold my camera for 50 frames, I have to shift left click here and then drag it like this and release my left click and shift. Now my camera is not going to rotate for 50 frames. Now I will go to the last frame and I will simply animate my camera like this. Turn off auto key, go to the first frame and play your animation. In the next lesson, we will learn track, truck and dolly camera rigs for single axis movements in 3ds Max.